Hello, Travel Bugs! We stayed in the adults-only Punta Cana resort Barceló Bavaro Beach. This is a full video tour of this all-inclusive resort so you know exactly what to expect. The Barceló Bavaro Beach Resort is on the gorgeous and world-famous Bavaro Beach, right next to the popular resort Barceló Bavaro Palace. In the hotel's beach, there are more than enough lounge chairs in the sitting area, well-spaced and shaded by fully grown palm trees. The water was lovely, amazingly clear, to the point you see the fish swimming with the naked eye. In addition, it was calm. Midday, there was some seaweed, but not sargassum, which plagues the Caribbean in the summer months. The Barceló Bavaro Beach is a tiny resort and has only one pool. The pool is big and has good depth. John is 5 feet and 6 inches tall, and the water was up to his neck in some areas. Our favorite pool features were the massaging water faucets and the bubbling section in the middle, which was very relaxing. Plenty of lounge chairs were available at all times and shaded areas. The Bohio Bar is next to the pool, but has no wet side. You have to come out of the pool to get a drink. You can have lunch at one of the two buffet restaurants, Caribe or La Brisa. The Caribe buffet restaurant is the larger of the two and the main buffet in the hotel. There are many food stations and therefore a lot of variety. This restaurant is open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. La Brisa, the smaller buffet, is closer to the beach and has a gorgeous view. This buffet closes at 5:30 p.m., making it a great place for a mid-afternoon snack. At night, it becomes a Mediterranean specialty restaurant. In addition to the Mediterranean, there is one more specialty restaurant, Chez Gourmet. The menu is international cuisine, and the restaurant is small, quaint, and beautiful. The staff is very attentive, and the food plating is creative. Specialty restaurants require a reservation to be made at guest services. There are three bars in the Barceló Bavaro Beach. Mamey Bar is located in the lobby. At night, it becomes a meeting spot after dinner. Bohio Bar is by the pool and near the beach. There is comfortable seating and is the best place to get a drink during the day. The third bar is located inside La Brisa restaurant. Its biggest selling point is the stunning view of the beach from this area.
Did you know you can book Punta Cana excursions online? We've handpicked the best tours and made them 100% online bookable at nittygrittytravelers.com/Punta Cana.
We booked a superior room. Our room had a good sized and good natural illumination. It was dated, but perfectly maintained. Two difficult attributes to balance. You'll see the bathroom to your right as soon as you enter the room. There were double vanities with a lot of counter space and oversized wall mirrors. This area was well illuminated by white light. There was also a small bench that we didn't think we'd use at all, but used it quite a bit. To the right, you'll find a wall-mounted magnifying mirror and a hairdryer. Right next to them is a door that separates the toilet and shower from the rest of the bathroom. This area is small and feels cramped. Most Punta Cana hotel rooms have stand-up showers with rain shower heads, but this room has a bathtub with just a handheld shower head. Before the bedroom and opposite the vanities, there's the closet. Its sliding doors are mirrors and has enough space inside to accommodate two people's belongings. Inside, you'll find an iron with an ironing board, plenty of hangers, the always welcome bathrobes with slippers, and a safe. This room area is separated from the bedroom area by a door. We had two full-size beds on the other side of the door with a night table in between. On top of the bed, a ceiling fan complemented the air conditioning unit. In front of the beds are three pieces of furniture, a luggage rack, a workstation/dresser, and a high cabinet with a coffee station on top and a mini bar inside. The mini bar is stocked with 4 cans of Presidente beer, 5 bottles of soda, and a big water bottle. The TV is above the cabinet, so not directly in front of the beds, and is about 55 inches. Next to the bedroom, the seating area consists of 2 wicker chairs and a coffee table. The balcony is quite small and has 2 plastic wicker chairs, a table, and a collapsible towel rack. The view of the beach from our balcony was stunning. The hotel's vegetation consists mainly of high palm trees and well taken care of grass and gardens. The exterior design of the room buildings is made to resemble wood and looks beautiful. In the lobby area, there are beautiful sculptures. The resort's layout is parallel to the beach, and it is a small property, so walking around is very easy. The Barceló Bavaro Beach Resort by itself is light on amenities. However, its sister resort, the Barceló Bavaro Palace, which is right next door, is loaded with amenities. You can use most of them as a guest of the Bavaro Beach. First, I'll list the on-site amenities at the Bavaro Beach and then move to the amenities you can access in the Bavaro Palace. The Barceló Bavaro Beach has a small theater where they perform the night shows, 3 hard surface tennis courts, 2 basketball courts, foosball, ping pong, and pool tables in the lobby area, a shuffleboard court, a giant chess set, a volleyball court, and soccer goals on the beach. You may use the following amenities in the Bavaro Palace, but be advised that you'll need to board the train to take you to most of them due to their distance from the Bavaro Beach. The train runs at reliable intervals from 8 a.m. to 2 a.m. You'll find a full-size soccer field and next to it, a baseball field. There are 2 paddle courts, 4 additional hard surface tennis courts, and another basketball court. There is also an escape room where you can play 3 different games for a fee. The Bavaro Palace also has a spa, and right next door, a medium-sized gym with multiple cardio machines, but only a few strength machines or free weights. There is a casino and a nightclub for nighttime entertainment. A 4-lane bowling alley shares a location with the arcade. Both amenities are pay-to-play, and you can exchange your winnings in the arcade for prizes. It has a mini golf course, a putting green, and a beautiful 18-hole golf course by the architect and designer P.B. Dye. You'll find different board games in the entertainment center of the Bavaro Palace, like dominoes, Monopoly, and Battleship. You may also use all the bars. Eat and drink at Striker's Sports Bar, use the coffee, rum, and cigars lounge, and eat at some of the specialty restaurants at night. The restaurants guests of the Bavaro Beach can use are Santa Fe Steakhouse, Coral, which serves seafood, and Hoyo 19 by the golf court. You may also eat at any of the 2 buffet restaurants. There was little to no entertainment during the day at the Barceló Bavaro Beach. When we stayed next door at the Bavaro Palace, the Barceló staff organized various games and activities like pool aerobics, pool stretching exercises, and a beach volleyball game. So if you want a more active day, head next door and come back whenever you want a more relaxed vibe. At night, the Bavaro Beach's night show was a live band playing bachata music in the theater, which you can dance to. Remember, you may also go to the palace for a more active nightlife. In another video, we'll explore the pros and cons of staying at the Bavaro Beach and the Bavaro Palace and which one we'd choose again when we return. Now click on this video for a more detailed tour of the Barceló Bavaro Palace, which you'll also have access to during your stay at the Bavaro Beach.